Our concern is we want to work with the hospitals to ensure that the patients, public, and nurses are protected.
The California Nurses Association is raising concerns about hospital safety. This all comes after a Sacramento area nurse became the first known healthcare worker to die from the H1N1 virus. That nurse worked at Mercy San Juan Medical Center in Carmichael. Mercy says it is following H1N1 prevention guidelines set by Sacramento County Public Health and the CDC. But some Mercy employees say the hospital is not taking proper precautions to prevent the spread of the virus. KCRA3's Lindsay Paulo explains.
51-year-old Karen Hayes, a nurse at Mercy San Juan Medical Center, died 2 weeks ago of acute respiratory failure, pneumonia, and H1N1 virus. Mercy San Juan and Sacramento County health officials say they don't know where she got the virus.
It's really tough to say where it might have come from.
But the California Nurses Association says it was likely at work.
We believe very likely. I mean, what nurses every day go into these hospitals are exposed to, in addition to H1N1, multiple infectious diseases.
Hospitals are supposed to prevent the spread of infectious diseases. Mercy told us today, safety of patients and staff is its top priority. But an internal Mercy memo obtained by KCRA3 calls that into question. The memo dated 2 days ago tells employees, due to a national shortage of N95 masks, use one properly fit-tested N95 mask per shift. N95 masks help prevent the spread of germs. Mercy told us it's following OSHA guidelines, which say if there isn't a sufficient supply of masks during a pandemic, it's okay to reuse them. OSHA also says reuse may increase chance of contamination. The U.S. Department of Health and Human Services says N95 masks should not be used more than once. Nurses told us they may be wearing contaminated masks going from one patient room to the next.
We think that the public needs to be educated about what measures the hospital has in place and should be asking the hospitals what measures they have in place.
The Nurses Association wants to talk to Hayes' family to learn more about her death and how hospitals are protecting nurses and patients. In Carmichael, Lindsay Paulo, KCRA 3 reports.
Mercy San Juan says it does not have any other employees at this time who are hospitalized with H1N1, and workers who call in sick with flu-like symptoms are told to stay home. When they're ready to come back to work, then they are screened to make sure that they are indeed healthy.